All right, so now that you know how to snap and zip your way across the timeline, let's delete everything here and start making our rough cut the right way. So what we wanna do here is we wanna look at our footage, decide which shots are crap, which shots are great, trim the fat off the good stuff, and then line it up in a sequence that we can fine tune in the next lesson. So it's like we want to lay out and prep all our ingredients before we start cooking, right? So I'm gonna show you lots of ways to do this. We're gonna start out slow and then we're gonna get faster and faster, okay? All right, so let's start by picking out some good shots from our footage here. And we're gonna start by just hovering our mouse from left to right over our clips. And I want you to notice what happens. It's playing a preview of our footage, right? So hovering is what I'm doing to even decide whether a clip is worthy enough to put over on my timeline. All right, so let's hover over these first two shots here. And I can see that these were the shots where that camera was face up on the ground and we were laying the blanket over the lens, right? And I remember this is a shot that we did twice and the second take was better. And a lot of times that's the case, that I'll look at the last take because that's the one where we perfected things, right? So here, I know we want this second clip, but we don't want all of it, right? We don't want the beginning of it where we're just staring at the sky. And I don't want the end of it where my face comes in here and I'm turning the camera off. I want to trim out only the good parts and just add that to my timeline. Now, if I click to select this clip, then I hover my mouse left to right, then you'll notice that I can't hover anymore. Hovering down here on a clip that's not selected, well, that lets me be way lazier. And so that is my preferred method of previewing. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go up to this edit menu and I am going to pick deselect all because I don't want this clip selected, I wanna hover. All right, now I am gonna hover over in this clip to the part where we want it to start. So where we want this clip to come in, and that is called the endpoint. And what letter does endpoint start with? Y'all are so smart, it starts with an I, that's right. So I'm gonna press the I key, and that is going to set my endpoint on this clip. And you'll notice that this little blue line down here has gotten shorter, and everything before our endpoint is grayed out and has been trimmed off the clip. Now I'm gonna hover over to the point in the shot where I want it to go out, right about there, and that is our out point. And what key are we gonna press to set our out point? Oh yeah, get it? Oh, you're gonna press O. And after we do that, then you'll notice our blue line has gotten even shorter. Everything after that out point has gotten trimmed off. And if we drag our clip to the timeline, zoom in a little bit here, and we play that back, then you'll notice that only the highlighted part has been added to our timeline, which is super efficient. I mean, that just looks so cute. Now, what if we decided we trimmed too much? Well, that's okay. If we select this clip on our timeline and we drag it out, then you'll see that everything is still there, nothing's been destroyed, and so it's all good. But in this case, we had it trimmed up right, so let's undo that. And now let's get another clip on this timeline. So we're gonna go back over to our panel with the footage in it, so make sure you click on that and you don't have the timeline selected anymore. And let's hover over these next couple shots, and I can see that these are the shots, that straightforward shot of Miles and I putting the blanket down. And again, this was a shot that we did twice, and I know that that second take was one that we perfected, so I want this shot right here. Now, I'm not gonna click to select it because if I do that, I can't be lazy and hover and preview it. But I also don't want our last clip up here selected. That makes me nervous because we ain't working on that clip, we're working on this one. And so, again, I'm gonna go up to our edit menu here and I'm going to pick deselect all. Cool, now I'm gonna hover over this clip to the point where I want it to come in. So let's go to our endpoint, maybe right about here. I'm gonna press the I key to set that. Go to my out point, maybe right about here. Press the O key to set that. And then drag it to my timeline. Now I'm gonna click back on the panel with our footage in it, and first thing I wanna do is I wanna deselect that last clip. So I'm gonna go up to the edit menu and go to deselect all. Now, if I'm going back and forth between my timeline panel and my footage bin here, then that's a lot of going up into this menu and going to deselect all, which is gonna take a while, so of course I use a keyboard shortcut. And you know, I have set a custom keyboard shortcut for deselect all that is conveniently located right beside the I and O keys that I'm using a lot when I'm doing this process. And I've set it to L for deselect all. You could also think of it as L for let go of that last clip. I know it's stupid. Look, I'm just trying to help you remember, okay? All right, so let's use that new keyboard shortcut. Let's press L to deselect all or to let go of that last clip. And now let's go on to our next shots and let's get a little faster. So our next shots are with the camera inside of that picnic basket where we're opening it up. And I can see from these first two shots here, I didn't have my jacket on, which was a continuity error. So I know I wanna use this third shot. So without clicking it, I'm just gonna hover, press the I key to set my endpoint, press the O key to set my out point. And now instead of dragging this clip all the way over to the timeline. That was a long journey, y'all. Let's undo that, and I'm gonna do the exact same thing real fast by just pressing the comma key. The comma key is going to insert any clip that you've got selected over here onto your timeline wherever the playhead is. That means that if this blue line is in the middle of a clip on your timeline, and then I press the comma key, Premiere is gonna insert your new clip smack dab in the middle of that existing clip on your timeline and split it in two. So let's undo that. And anyway, to remember that the comma key is what inserts something onto your timeline, you can think that if you were gonna insert something into a sentence, you might set it off in commas. Speaking of inserting, another way you can insert clips onto the timeline is to click on a clip, and then while you're dragging it, press the command key, and then you see those little triangles that are pointing to the right? That means that wherever you release the clip, it's gonna be inserted there on your timeline. All right, so at this point, we've gone over a lot of shortcuts, so if your head is about to explode, then that's all right, I feel you. We're gonna take a minute here, and we're gonna review this keystroke choreography and show you just how fast you can cut and trim clips for your rough cut using these shortcuts, and I'm also gonna drop a sick beat behind it while we review so that hopefully you can remember these a little better. And if you're watching this lesson as a preview on YouTube, then you can hear that sick beat in our music video, which is called Shortcuts, and it's set to the song Money by Cardi B, and the link to that video is in the description below. Now I'm gonna go over to this last clip, and I'm gonna hover over it to remind myself what it was, and I can see that it was that clip with the camera inside the picnic basket while we were opening the basket and unloading it, right? So if I hover over our next clips, I can see that they are basically the same exact action, but they're just from a different angle. So they're with the camera shooting from overhead, right? So obviously I can't include both the last shot with the camera inside the basket and the shot from overhead in full of the same exact action, or it's gonna look like we did the same thing twice, right? But at this point when I'm making my rough cut, like I'm not trying to decide which one of these shots I'm using or which parts of which of these shots I'm using. I'm just trying to get anything that's potentially usable on my timeline. All right, so in this first shot, I don't have my jacket on. That's a continuity error, so we're not including that clip. In the second shot, you can barely see it, but I do have my jacket on, so that's good, because I really like the way this shot starts, the way we sit down on the blanket. And so now I'm just gonna press O for out point. I'm not even gonna press I for end point, because I like where the clip starts as it is. And now I can just click that clip to select it and press the comma key to get it on the timeline. All right, now I'm gonna press L to let go of that last clip, deselect all. And now I'm gonna hover and see if there are any other parts of this clip that we want. Like, are we ever gonna open the basket? Nope, all right. So there's nothing else in this clip that I want, but let's just pretend that I did want something here at the end of the clip. I could set a new endpoint and cut off everything else before that. And then I could click to select it, press the comma key to insert. And now if we press the up arrow to go back to the beginning of that previous clip we trimmed, you'll see that it has not been affected at all. And so we could take different excerpts from the same clip and we can reset in and out points on a clip, and we can also clear in and out points on a clip. So we have all the control, people.
Oh, that's creepy.
All right, now we're gonna go back to this panel with our footage in it. We're gonna press the L key to let go of that last clip and deselect all. And now I want you to notice in the bottom right of this last clip that we just inserted on the timeline, we've got these blue little icons for a video footage icon and an audio waveform icon. And anytime you see something that's highlighted in blue in Premiere, that means it's been selected. And so this is telling us that we have used this footage in our timeline before or somewhere in this project in a sequence already. And if we go up to this clip above this, you'll see that it's white, it's not highlighted in blue. We haven't used this footage. And so those little usage indicators can be helpful for you.
Yes.
By the way, we can also go up to the top of this panel here and click on this down caret icon to see where exactly in this project we've used this footage. And then you can select an instance in this drop-down menu, and it's gonna take you right to the time code where the clip was used, which is really useful. Like if you tweaked a clip over here in your sequence just right and you wanna copy and paste it over here in another place in your sequence. Another thing to know is that you can actually change this little preview image that Premiere is showing you when you're looking at your footage in icon view. And so if we look at this clip right here, you can see that it actually starts out black before we open the picnic basket. But if I hover away from it, like I have no idea what that clip is about. And so I could tell Premiere, I want you to show me this preview image when I'm not hovering over this clip by right-clicking this clip and saying set poster frame. And now if I press the L key to deselect that clip, it's showing us that preview image. It's set a new poster frame. So that can also be helpful. All right, so let's take a look at our next shots. For these next shots, I remember that we actually had some focus issues for these shots, and I can't remember which one had the focus issues. Actually, that's a lie. I know that it was the first one and that we nailed it on the second take, but let's just pretend that I couldn't remember which one had the focus issues, and I can't really tell because these are tiny little icons here. I need to take a closer look. So to take a closer look at a clip, I can double click it, and then it's going to show up in a panel called the Source Monitor panel. And to tell you a little bit more about this panel, I'm just going to drag this over into its own little area. Now, the Source Monitor panel goes straight to the source file, that is. So it's going to show you a preview of a source asset in your project. It's not showing a preview of what's on your timeline. That is what's showing up in your program monitor panel. Because remember, you're creating a TV program like your grandma used to watch. But now I'm going to drag this source monitor panel back over my program monitor panel in a tab, because Premiere can take up a lot of your screen real estate. It has so many features and they're so awesome, but it can make things a little tight. And so we're just going to put these layered on top of each other. And now you'll see that this panel is pretty similar to our program monitor. And we've got playback resolution down here, which I want to make sure I set to full, which might make my computer a little mad, but I need to see things in full res to know what's going on with this focus here. All right, now I'm going to press FF to fast forward through this clip. And now I can already see the focus going in and out. This is the one that had the focus issues. This is not the clip we want. So I'm going to go over to this other clip, double click it, and open it in the source monitor. And now I'm gonna go toward the beginning, press FF to fast forward. This looks like it might be an endpoint. I'm gonna press I to set the endpoint, just like I did over there in icon view in that other panel. Press FF again to fast forward. Let's press O for an out point before I get up. And maybe I'll drag this playhead in a little bit more before I get on my knees. And press O again to reset that out point. Now I'll go down to my timeline panel, press the down arrow key to make sure I'm at the end of this timeline so the clip gets inserted here. I'll go back up to my source monitor panel and I'll press the comma key, just like we did before, to insert it on the timeline. You can also add footage to the timeline from the source monitor by just dragging it from the preview screen up top, or you can add just the video from a clip by dragging from this video icon here, or you can add just the audio from a clip by dragging from this audio icon here. And so the source monitor panel is another way to trim and insert clips onto your timeline if you want to see them up close and personal. All right, how you doing? You need a stretch break? Maybe some coffee, healthy snack, a not so healthy snack. If you need a little self-care, then now is a great time because That sound means we have reached another practice pause point, which means if you haven't been following along up to this point, now is the time to hit the pause button and practice what we've been talking about. So I want you to take maybe a quarter of the video clips in your project, and I want you to practice trimming them primarily in icon view using that keystroke choreography that we talked about. So hover IO, click comma L. And you can also practice trimming your clips up in the source monitor in that big view like we just did as well. Hey y'all, I'm Mary. I'm a filmmaker and I teach a course showing you how to make videos for your brand. And this is a preview of one of the editing lessons. And if you want to watch the full lesson, you can do that online for free at the link on screen or in the description below. All right, bye y'all.